Hello, hi everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. So today we are going to discuss about problems on surface tension under fluid mechanics subject. So to solve the problems on surface tension, so we're having the different consequences of surface tension. So that is the surface tension in liquid droplet and surface tension in hollow bubble and surface tension in liquid jet. Okay, so these are all the three important consequences where we can came across surface tension. For each consequences, we are having different types of pressure equation. So that is the whatever the pressure exerted will be different for all these three consequences. So by considering surface tension effect, so we are deriving the what is the pressure acting in that liquid. So first we have a formula here. So these are all the important formula we have listed. For liquid droplet, it is given the P is equal to 4 sigma by D. Pressure is equal to 4 sigma by D, where P is pressure in Newton per meter square, and sigma is the surface tension in Newton per meter, and D is the diameter of the droplet in meter. So this is the equation of pressure. So whenever the liquid droplet is given and the surface tension for this liquid droplet is given, then when they ask to find the pressure or any term, so we can use this equation. So based on the liquid droplet condition. Okay, so this is only made for liquid droplet. Next, for hollow bubble. So here hollow bubble, so that is like a soap bubble. We are having two surfaces, one is inside, one is outside, which is exposed to atmospheric air. Okay, by considering these two surfaces, we are having the equation P is equal to 8 sigma by D. Next, for a liquid jet, we are having P is equal to sigma into 2L divided by LD, where L is nothing but it's the length of the jet. And we have one more equation for P. So this is for this one, hollow bubble. So because the hollow bubble, it's exposed to two surfaces, right? It is having two surfaces. One is inside surface, one is outside surface. So whatever the pressure developed within the surface and outside of the surface will be different. So therefore, the total pressure we can take P inside minus P outside. So by taking this equation, we can find what is the pressure acting inside and what is the pressure acting outside. So these are some important formulas I have listed. So by using all these three, and based on the condition what they have given in the problem, we can further proceed in solving problems. So next, here we have taken one problem. So that is the problem is like this: the pressure outside the droplet of water of diameter 0.04 mm is 10.32 newton per centimeter square. That is atmospheric pressure they had given. Full stop. Calculate the pressure within the droplet if the surface tension is given as 0.0725 newton per meter of water. So they had given here the pressure they had given. So that is outside of the pressure liquid droplet is given. So that liquid droplet is having a diameter of 0.04 mm. So we need to calculate the pressure developed within the droplet if the surface tension of that liquid droplet is 0.0725 newton per meter. So this is they had given. So first we'll list down what is the data given. So we're writing the data given. So the data given is they had given the diameter of the droplet of water. So diameter, it says d small d 0.04 mm. And we'll convert this to meter, 0.04 into 10 per minus 3 meter, right? 1 meter is equal to 1000 mm. So therefore 1 mm is equal to 10 per minus 3 meter. Then they had given the atmospheric pressure So here we are having this formula that total pressure is equal to P inside minus P outside. Okay, so here they had given the droplet. Hence the droplet will have a two surface. One is inside and one is outside. Okay, the inside pressure will be different and outside surfaces will be exposed to the atmosphere. Okay, so whatever the pressure exerted on the outside surface will be nothing but it is the pressure of atmosphere. It is the atmospheric pressure. So hence we can take here P outside is nothing but P atmospheric. Okay, P outside is nothing but P atmospheric. So hence we can take this P atmospheric they had given 10.32 newton per centimeter square. Now we'll convert this to what? Newton per meter square. Okay, so just 10.32 into it become 10 per 4 newton per meter square. So why this is means? Because 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. So just put here centimeter to meter, what will become? It become 10 raised to minus 2. So just put here 10 raised to minus 2 whole square. It's 10 raised to minus 4. If you take to the numerator, it will become 10 raised to 4. So this is the conversion. Okay. So if you want how we have converted, I'll show here. 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. Then 1 centimeter is nothing but it is 10 raised to minus 2 meter. Okay. So here we are having Newton per centimeter square. Let's say, so this is the unit they had given for a pressure. So I'll keep Newton as it is and I'll convert this centimeter square to meter square. So to convert what is 1 centimeter to meter, it is 10 raised to minus 2. Just put 10 raised to minus 2 and it is centimeter square. So just I'm squaring this one. So then it will become Newton divided by, and it will be in meter square, right? We have converted centimeter to meter square. So Newton divided by this one is 10 raised to minus 4. So 2 2s are 4. So that minus sign is there, 10 raised to minus 4. Meter square. Then if you take this 10 raised to minus 4 towards the numerator, it will become what? Newton per meter square. So this value will going to become 10 raised to 4. So this value will be multiplied over here and the unit will be Newton per meter square. I have kept it here. So this is the conversion what we are having. So this is about the pressure. And the next one they had given, the surface tension. So the surface tension is indicated by a symbol sigma. It is 0.0725 Newton per meter. So it is in SI unit, don't bother about the unit conversion. Next, we need to find what is the pressure within the droplet, that is P inside. We need to find. Okay, so first we'll write what is the formula to find this P inside. So to find P inside, we're having P, pressure exerted is nothing but it's a P inside minus P outside. We're having this one. So we have a P outside. We need to find P inside. To calculate this P inside, we require what is P. To calculate this P, we are having for a liquid droplet. For a liquid droplet, because the given problem is droplet, it's not a bubble. So for a liquid droplet, we are having the formula what? For a liquid droplet, P is equal to 4 sigma by D. P is equal to 4 sigma by D. So just put this one, P is equal to 4 sigma by D. It is equal 4 into sigma they had given. What is sigma? 0.0725 divided by, and D is they had given, it's a 0.04 into 10 power minus 3. So just do the calculation by using calculator. So we're getting 4 into 0.0725 divided by 0.04 into 10 raised to minus 3. So it will be coming 7250. 7250 will be the magnitude. 7250. And what is the unit of pressure? Pressure of unit is Newton per meter square. So this is the pressure developed. Okay. So by using this one, next we can calculate what is the pressure developed inside the cylinder. So we are having P is equal to P inside minus P outside. So P we have calculated is 7250 and P inside we need to calculate minus P outside. It is given as 10.32 into 10 raised to 4. So therefore it become what? P inside is equal to 7250 plus 10.32 into 10 power 4. Now do the calculation. 7250 plus 10.32 into 10 power 4. So the answer is 110450. If you want a simplified answer, just press engineering. It is going to give it is this simplified answer. 110.45 into 10 power 3 Newton per meter square. So this is the value of P inside. So this is the value of the pressure. So within the droplet. So when the bubble or so when the droplet is subjected to a surface tension of 0.0725 Newton per meter. So this is how we need to solve the problem related to surface tension. So thank you for watching this one.